Okay, good morning. It's Wednesday and today we're at Universal. We're gonna try to check in to Cabana Bay, which is where we're staying for the night. Really exciting. Oh, that's the Hulk, right? The green one?
Yeah, the green one.
Yeah. So we'll have a little bit of time in the morning. We'll take a break in the afternoon and then we can be here the whole night. And then we're gonna hope to get into
Turn left onto Adventure Way.
I got my Hogwarts shirt on. I'm pretty. I'm so excited. We haven't been here, or I haven't been here since 2013. So I'm really excited. Jen had to come for work. When was that? Last year?
Last summer.
Last summer. So she's been down here. She's seen both sides of Universal and Islands of Adventure. I have not. So I'm really looking forward to it, and we'll take you along the way.
We're gonna do it.
The sign is so cool. It's a 50s theme, right, Jen?
Yeah, 50s, 60s.
Oh, it's so cool. We made it in. We're in City Walk. It's walkway place. I don't know what it is. We are heading into City Walk, I should say. But the ride over from the hotel was super easy and convenient, and they dropped us off right here. Like, perfect. Worth it already. Pay for convenience, definitely. Honestly, probably moving faster. Here? Yeah. It probably would be.
I would imagine someday that'll happen.
That is the Toothsome Chocolate Emporium that we hope to eat at tonight. There it is, Islands of Adventure. Jen and I, last time we came, booked it so fast through Seuss-Land that we completely missed the entire part of it. Maybe we'll see it this year. There we go. Nice and quiet. Just the way we like it. We're heading in. 10 minute wait. We do have breakfast at the Three Broomsticks, in case you were wondering. We came in Honey Dukes to explore the candies because it's not very busy right now. It's really cool. Kim, what are you gonna get?
Chocolate frog, and then
oh, she's so cool. There's so many things she's so excited about.
I mean, like,
there's the chocolate frog. There's the chocolate frog. We got one of those last time. It was fun. Here's the Hogsmeade station timetable and fares. It's pretty cool. Okay, we're getting on Hogwarts Express. This will be Kim's first time over in Universal side, Diagon Alley.
I can't wait to get
So we are in line right now to get on the Simpson ride. We're waiting up here at the top. Across the way is Diagon Alley. And over here to your right is Sear Factory and Men in Black. We just got off Men in Black, so everything so far has been a walk-on. Alright, we just got off the Simpson ride. That was not what I was expecting. But they got lots of merchandise. And donut. $30, you can have that. So we just got off the Simpson ride. We were looking around the gift shop and didn't see anything but those big giant donuts. Those look pretty good, they smell pretty good. We are about ready to head back over to Diagon Alley to grab some lunch, buy some souvenirs, and then I think we're gonna head back to the hotel to relax for a little bit. It's been a long day so far and we got a lot done, but I'm tired. It was a late night, so hopefully we'll get a little bit of sleep so we can enjoy the rest of Universal here. But so far, did a couple rides, no shopping, just a lot of looking, so hopefully we'll do some damage financially soon.
Here's a view from our room, which we have a Volcano Bay room, view room, I should say. And it's a really pretty view. You can see all the water park. And it's going on, it's a little bit after 5 right now, and the park there is almost dead, so I'm not sure what time they close, but it's pretty dead right now. And then look at this beautiful sunset that is going on right now. I just noticed this. I don't know if you can really appreciate it from the camera, but it is stunning. And then down yonder, we can see our beloved Disney property still. I'm gonna just try to zoom in for you guys. And if you can see, oh gosh, it's gonna get real bouncy. There in the middle, that would be Epcot. To the left is Hollywood Studios. To the right is the Swan and Dolphin. And then if I go slowly over here, that little thing is Everest.
Good evening. Oh! Hulk just went by as soon as I started up to say something. But we're back at Islands of Adventure. City Walk, like Jen had said, our City Walk's still open. They're open late, but Universal closed at 6. So we're here to kind of check out what we didn't get to see earlier. I have already seen this part of the park, but I think we're gonna try to get on Kong and then go look at the castle. It's gonna be all lit up and have a design, so we'll take you along and show you that. But this part we've already been to, and unfortunately we can't ride Spider-Man because it makes me sick. So no fun, no thank you. Look at that big sandwich. Ooh, it has a sardine on it and a lobster. Ew. There's Popeye. Toot, toot. Crazy water rides, and they will really, really get you wet. Not just a little bit, I've seen people soaking wet. So one thing I mentioned is that a lot of the water rides around here seem to get people really wet, but they do have these little drying machines that you can pay and then you'll get dried off. I don't know how well they work, but I've seen people get in them but not get out, so I guess that they work pretty good. But yeah, you can pay, go on a machine, get you dry. Okay,
We're gonna go on Kong. I've never even seen the movies. I don't think Jen has either, but we're gonna get on. These dinosaurs are fighting over pizza. Jen.
That's what Kim and I get.
Yes. What did you think of Kong, Jen?
It was really good.
Oh my gosh.
Cool, because we were the only ones in our whole row.
So yes.
We got to see both sides really nice.
Oh my gosh, yeah, it was cool. And
we literally walked right on.
We walked right on, and the guy scared the crap out of us.
Oh yeah, there was a guy hanging.
Like, on the line part.
Yeah, the queue.
And he scared the crap out of me.
And we just said, this is a preview for Fortnite.
Yes. Oh, look, it's a Jeep.
Beep, beep in the Jeep, Jeep.
Oh, look. I forgot. Ah! So we're going over to look at the castle because they are projecting stuff on it. Look at that. How pretty. All lit up. We're back.
What day is
this? This is the busiest we've seen anything all day. It's really pretty with all the lights and the snow. You're a wizard, Kim. Gryffindor.
Come on, back
constant. We have a hunchback. That's cute.
Thank you.
get a table. Here's a look next door to Hard Rock. And here's City Walk.
The Chocolate Emporium. Here's the menu. It's big. There's a story about the owners. Drinks. Lots of drinks. The appetizers. We're gonna try the warm chocolate almond bread and the tacos. And then they have lots of other stuff too. Jen, take a little bite. Tell me what you think.
They're good and crispy.
Ooh. And here's our bread. It looks so good. Yum. Okay, so we got our meals. I got the mushroom and chicken risotto. Looks really good. Kim got a cheeseburger and the biggest fry or kettle chips you've never met.
What? How big that is.
Put it up to your head for reference. Okay, we hated our appetizers. They were horrible. As you can see. Take a chip. Good? Alright, well, we're gonna dig in and see what we think.
Okay, so we just finished up our dinner and I had the cheeseburger, which I haven't had a cheeseburger or red meat in forever, and it was so good. Well, I had red meat, but I haven't had a cheeseburger. It was delicious. I tried Jen's risotto. It was really good.
It was really good.
The appetizers were both delicious. We're gonna split a milkshake. We first went in strong. We're each gonna have one, and then we ate way too much, so we're gonna split it. But our waitress is Christine, and you have to have her. She's so good. She's really attentive. She's doing an excellent job. So it's really, really good. And like the ambiance in here is so cool.
Fun.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. It's a fun place. So.
It's like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory meets steampunk.
Yeah, it's really cool. So I definitely recommend coming here. And prices are reasonable.
Yes, prices are really reasonable. My entree for the chicken and mushroom risotto was $15. Kim, yours was
$13, I think, something like that.
And the bread was $3, and the nacho, the tater tot nachos were $10.95.
Yeah. So I think reasonable price. The milkshake is $12. And it ranged, if you got like more detailed milkshake with all these toppings, I think it was like $13 or $14.
Yeah,
maybe.
Like $13.50, $14. Yeah.
But I can't wait. We'll show you what the milkshake looks like because they've been looking amazing so far. And yeah, I didn't want to get sick, so we're going to share it.
We may die if we do that otherwise. It's the moment of truth. It is here. We went with the Nutella milkshake. And it comes in a souvenir glass with a pretty straw. Kim, what are your thoughts? I think that face reads it all.
It looks delicious.
All right, we'll let you know what we think if we survive. We may be in a sugar coma afterwards.
Okay, so this was delicious. We didn't need a lot of the whipped cream around it, but yeah. The Nutella ice cream, or hazelnut ice cream.
So good.
And this nice lady came over and she asked us if we wanted her souvenir glass, so they're gonna clean these out and then we'll each have our own souvenir glass.
That was very nice of her.
Oh, but we are like,
this is so dying. Good.
I'll be that all night on a sugar
rush. The ice cream is light and not too heavy. Just the right amount of sweetness. It wasn't too sugary. And it wasn't overwhelming.
No, it was so, like, it wasn't like so powerful, like chocolate hazelnut.
Yeah.
It was good.
It was really good.
It was so good. But now I'm freezing.
Show the face of defeat. You missed the guy behind you, photo bombing you.
Oh.
That was cute. All right. Well,
I think this is it for. No. Well, maybe we might show a little bit of the
hotel.
Hotel.
If we feel like it.
If we feel like it. We're exhausted. It's 9 o'clock at night and I'm eating a milkshake.
That's okay. That's dessert time.
Which we haven't really had.
Not really.
I mean, we had dessert during the day.
Well, that's all right. Cream, that's different.
No dessert after dinner.
No. So here's a look at our view at night, which I think is pretty cool. You can see the Orlando Eye and the volcano that's steaming. And all the water slides and the Belize River. Looks pretty cool.